Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. And we're going to start today with a history lesson in honor of the Great Pyramids. We're going to build our own little pyramid. We're not going to use big, huge blocks of stone. We're going to use little bricks. Now keep in mind, when they built the Great Pyramids out of these huge, big blocks of stones, they didn't use complicated machines like cranes and bulldozers and dump trucks. So what did they use? Well, we're going to take a closer look at what they used. They didn't have complicated machines to move these big blocks of stone, but they did have simple machines, and those simple machines made their work easier. And that's the big idea. We're going to take a closer look at the wheel and axle. So let's start with a question. How much does this brick weigh? To figure that out, we're going to use our spring scale. So take a look at this. I'm going to lift the brick off the table and take a look at our spring scale. It's reading a little over 1,000 grams, or right at 1,000 grams. Now those big blocks of stones in the real Great Pyramids weighed a lot more. There's no way they could lift those blocks up and carry them. So let's see what happens if we try and drag this brick, if they could drag those big blocks of stone, and see how many grams it takes to move this brick if I drag it. So now let's try dragging our brick. I get it started moving, and I can look, it's between 300 and 400 grams as I drag the brick. So it was easier to drag this brick than it was to lift it up and carry it. But the blocks that made up the Great Pyramid were so big and so heavy that they were even really difficult to drag. So the people back in history had a problem. How do we move these massive, huge, big blocks of stone? Well, through science, we've discovered that you usually solve problems by asking the right questions. What if? What if I cut these trees down and use these round logs to go under the block? I wonder if that's going to make our work easy. So we've placed our block on top of these round tree logs, and now we're going to pull it and see if our work is easier. Let's try it out. So I gently pull. Believe it or not, my spring scale barely moved off of 0 grams. It hardly took any energy to move this block on these round tree logs. But what do we do now? We're out of tree logs. So that means we would have to pick up this tree log and move it to the front, pick up this tree log and move it to the front, pick up this tree log and keep moving the tree logs to the front from the back. Well, that's a lot of work too. Well, good news, science is not finished yet. Well, what if I take this tree log and cut sections off of the tree log? Let's see what we're left with when we do that. So what do we have? Well, we have the wheel. But how do I attach this wheel to our block? Well, through science, we've discovered that we can attach two wheels with an axle. This piece of wood is going to be our axle, but I need some way to attach the axle to the wheel. And to do that, I'm going to use styrofoam. Now, cutting styrofoam is really not a kid-friendly thing to do. It's difficult, and you don't want kids using sharp knives or cutters. So we came up with a really kid-friendly way to allow kids to cut styrofoam. It may not be the prettiest, but it works. So all I'm going to do is trace my wheel on my styrofoam and use something thin like this screwdriver and just go around the wheel, punching down the styrofoam, taking my time, working my way around the wheel. It's pretty easy to push through the styrofoam. And once I get all the way around, now all I need to do is push, and it comes right out. Now we need to take our styrofoam plug, put it into our wheel, and now I'm ready to attach my axle. Just going to push my axle into the styrofoam on both sides. And it looks like I have a wheelbase that's ready to roll. We also took a clear straw and put it through the wooden axle, so our wheel and axle can spin quite easily. Now we have to attach this to our block, and we're going to use some tape to do that. One piece there, one piece here. Now let's see how our block rolls. may not be the prettiest thing, but I don't have to keep moving my tree logs in front of it. It always has some wheels attached, so now it rolls as I push it. Think about how far we've come since the age of the pyramids and how we use the wheel and axle today. Bicycles, skateboards, rollerblades, cars, airplanes, you name it. Everywhere we look, we can find the wheel and axle at work. And that wheel and axle makes moving things so much easier than if we had to drag them or lift them or carry them. Simple machines at work is a beautiful thing. It's so beautiful, I might just hop on this bike and have some fun rolling around. Science is so cool, especially when it helps make our work so much easier. If you want to learn more about simple machines or the wheel and axle, check out our links in the video description. Thanks for watching.